Allahu Akbar.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah. Wa nashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah. Nashhadu anna muhammadan abdullahi wa rasuluh. Wa rahmatuhu lil alameen. Sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Amma ba'd. First, let me just say to our dear brothers in ICNA, all the organizers, Jazakumullah khairan, for inviting us over and over, though we're getting old now. So you need to get a new generation to come for the conferences, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward them, bless them, increase them in knowledge, and give them all the blessings, inshallah. Now, talking about the Prophet, alayhi salatu wasalam, in any aspect, you can pick up anything of the Prophet, alayhi salatu wasalam. They call it in Arabic as-sahl al-mumtani'. Sahl is very easy, but mumtani' means unapproachable, inaccessible. The reason being is that although there are so many books and lectures and millions of things that are written about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, throughout the literature that you get in Islam, still you cannot do what we call sufficient justice to what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is. The summary that we have about the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam is what Aisha radiallahu anha said when he was asked about the Prophet. She said, كان خلقه القرآن. Literally, anything that Allah said in the Quran, the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam was exactly that, in every aspect of it. So you take every aspect that Allah spoke about, then you will see that the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam actually fulfilled it. But in particularly in matters of giving, there are so many descriptions. There are books written, they call them al-shamail, like the characteristic books of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Among the best descriptions is that they said, كان أجود الناس, the most generous ever was Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they said, وَكَانَ أَجْوَدُ مَا يَكُونُ فِي رَمَضَانِ. And especially in the month of Ramadan, the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam used to go to يعني the maximum. And the description they gave about him also, they said, وَكَانَ أَجْوَدَ مِنَ الْرِيحِ الْمُرْسَلَةِ. الْرِيحِ طبعا is the wind, and the wind that carries the good, like wind that carries pollination, that breathes and so on, and he was even more generous than that. This is also reflected in the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام companions. There are so many incidents that happened that actually reflect this. There is one of the incidents that happened to, they said, immediately after the death of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, people basically were completely taken by the death of Rasulullah. They couldn't believe it. When you know the incident that happened, and you can imagine maybe a week, 2 weeks, and people were completely shattered. They used to sit in the masjid, everybody crying, and they're waiting. They don't know what's going on. One of these incidents that took place that was reported by Abdullah ibn Abbas, just to reflect what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam actually said. He said, a man came, and they were in i'tikaf, basically, in the masjid of the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam. So he said, this man sat beside him. Now, Abdullah ibn Abbas looked at him. Abdullah was young at that time. So he asked the man, do you need anything? Alaka haja. This is the question that even the Prophet used to ask, by the way. Whenever he sees somebody like in distress, somebody who's not, he will ask him, Alaka haja, do you need anything? If he says no, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam then will ask him, Ma bika, what is wrong with you? Because he notices what he reads, what people are. So the companions, especially Abdullah ibn Abbas, they used to do the same. So he said, when this man came and sat beside him, the natural question was, he said to him, Alaka haja. The man didn't say anything, but he noticed that he said his tears were running. You know, when somebody needs something, he doesn't want to speak, whatever reason for it. So he felt that this man really needs something. So he took his hand, took him out of the masjid, and he said to him, if you need anything, don't think because I am sitting in i'tikaf, I cannot help you. And then he said to him, by Allah, I heard, and he pointed to the grave of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said to him, I heard this with my own ears. when somebody came and asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the question he asked him at the time, he said that a person came and asked the Prophet and he said to him, Ya Rasulullah, who is the best person of us? The answer was swift. He said to him, Anfa'ahu bilinnas. The person who is more useful is the person, useful to people is the best person. He didn't say the one who prays a lot, the one fast a lot. He said, Anfa'ahu bilinnas. Then right out he asked him, he said to him, what is the best of deeds? What are the deeds that you think are the best? That summarizes what I'm going to say to you, because this is a beautiful narration that he has. He said to him, خَيْرُ النَّاسِ أَنْفَعَهُمْ لِلنَّاسِ وَخَيْرُ الْأَعْمَالِ. And he listed, I'm going to give you the list he had, actually 8 things. He said to him, سُرُور تُدْخِلْهُ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِ مُسْلِمِ. Surur. So يعني, you make a person happy, a joy. You make them feel good about themselves. And you know the hadith that is very famous where the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام says, تبسمك في وجه أخيك الصدقة. Yeah, just to give a smile or to have a good face about a person, that in itself is a charity from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he said, surur تدخله على قلب مسلم. That if you feel somebody who is in distress, somebody who needs just to uplift him, give him some kind of joy, some kind of happiness, some kind of hope. The second, he said, أو تطرد عنه جوع. And if a person is hungry, you know they said, then you feed that person. Because feeding, by the way, is one of the highest things. They said, the first thing Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam was heard saying when he went to Medina was, he said, أطعم الطعام وأفش السلام وصلوا بالليل والناس نيام. Like he said to people that you feed people, spread peace, and pray nightly prayers by yourself. By the way, there is a long narration was compiled by Imam Ahmed. And in it, actually, the Prophet said, like, number of things. The Prophet used to say, they used to call them al-thulathiyat. Like many of the hadith of the Prophet will say, three like this, three like that, three like that. Many of the hadith. For instance, I'll give you this one. This one is a long one. Imam Ahmed put it all together, although it is spread in different books of hadith. He said, the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said, ثلاثٌ مهلكات means three things are destructive. They destroy a Muslim. وَثَلَاثٌ مُنْجِيَاتْ or مُنْجِيَاتْ and three things save a Muslim. Like a backdrop of this. وَثَلَاثٌ كَفَّارَاتْ and three things wipe our sins. وَثَلَاثٌ دَرَجَاتْ he said, and three things elevate us in ranks in paradise. طبعاً the Prophet said, الجنة مئة درجة like paradise is 100 ranks. He said, between one rank and the second rank is between the heavens and the earth. بين المشرق والمغرب. So if you want to just quickly go over this before we continue for this 8 things the Prophet said, he said, فَأَمَّا الْمُهْلِكَاتِ فَشُحٌّ مُطَاعٌ وَهَوًا مُتَّبَعٌ وَإِعْجَابُ الْمَرْءِ بِنَفْسِهِ. He said the three things that destroy a Muslim, and he wants us to be very careful about them. He said, شُحٌّ مُطَاعٌ miserliness or stinginess that will hold you from doing good. From giving money, from helping people, from giving time, from giving a hand, from helping any person. So he said, شُحٌّ مُطَاعٌ وَهَوًا مُتَّبَعٌ how is desire? And he said, when you have a desire that holds you and redirects you from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or sway you from Allah. وَإِعْجَابُ الْمَرْءِ بِنَفْسِهِ and false pride. People have false pride, people are arrogant. Normally they don't care about others, so they don't help them. These are the three things that are very destructive. Against them, the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام says, وَثَلَاثٌ مُنْجِيَاتٌ three things save a Muslim, save a believer basically. He said, one, خَشْيَةُ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى فِي السِّرِّ وَالْعَلَانِيَةِ that you become mindful of Allah, whether you are by yourself or with others. Many times I tell my children that if you really want to test how pious you are, see what you do when nobody sees you. When you are in your room with your laptop or with iPad, nobody can see you. That is where you test your piety. And this is why we say, اتَّقُوا ذُنُوبُ الْخَلَوَاتِ like when you are by yourself, that's the real test of how pious you are. So the Prophet said, خَشْيَةُ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى فِي السِّرِّ وَالْعَلَانِيَةِ that you become mindful of Allah, whether you are by yourself or with other people. He said, وَالْقَصْدُ في الفقر والغنى that also become moderate, whether you are extremely rich or extremely poor. Always moderation is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to have. And then he said, وَالْعَدْلِ فِي الْغَضْبِ وَالْرِضَى. And that you become just, alhamdulillah, Asif was talking about justice and ihsan. He said, and to be just, whether you are happy with the person or you are angry with him. Even with enemies, you know, in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَا يَجْرِمَنَّكُمْ شَنَآنُ قَوْمٍ عَلَىٰ أَلَّا تَعْدِلُوا اِعْدِلُوا هُوَ أَقْرَبُ لِلتَّقْوَى. Like he said, the animosity or the hatred of other people towards you should not sway you from being justice. Because justice is justice to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, then he said the three things that wipe our sins, very simple things. He said, إِسْبَاغُ الْوُضُوءِ عَلَى الْمَكَارِهِ إِنْتِظَارُ الصَّلَاةِ بَعْضُ الصَّلَاةِ وَنَقْلُ الْأَقْدَامِ إِلَى الْجَمَاعَاتِ. The three things that wipe sins. Every time you make wudu, the Prophet said your sins will be dropped. With every drop of water you use to make wudu, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cleanse you from sins. Or managing your time and your mind with the times of prayer. Every time you are thinking about prayer, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive your sins. You want to go out, first thing that comes to your mind, am I going to miss a prayer? Where am I going to pray? What is it that I'm going to do? And so on. And the third, he says, inaqlu al-aqdam. And this is also part of giving. Every time you take your footsteps to anything that helps people, like now we have janazah prayer, functions, fundraising, whatever you have. Every step you take, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wipes your sins with it. Then he said the last three things that actually elevate you in paradise. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam says, إطعام الطعام, just like what he said in Medina, إفشاء السلام والصلاة بالليل والناس نيام. This is the part that I mentioned. He said, you share food and give people food or feed people and spread peace among people. And the third one, he says that you pray at night. So Ibn Abbas went on, this is the hadith when he said that you bring joy, because these things bring joy to people's hearts. Or تطرد عنه جوع. أو تكشف عنه قربة. Like when a person is in distress, and you know, in the other hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, من نفس عن مؤمن قربة من قرب الدنيا نفس الله عنه قربة من قرب يوم القيامة. If you relieve a person of a hardship or a distress or a difficulty in this dunya, Allah will compensate you in the akhirah, even for that time when no one except what you did and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will do for you. Then he said, أو تقضي عنه دين. And you know the dain, like if a person is in heavily indebted. By the way, even if you give them a loan, you know the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام says, القرض الحسن كالصدقة. يعني when you give a person a soft loan, a loan that does not have interest or anything, he said is like giving charity, although it is غرض, because you help a person for it. Then the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام says, ومن مشى فيها, this is what Ibn Abbas said to this man, وَمَنْ مَشَى فِي حَاجَةَ أَخِيهِ, he said, it is better for him than praying even in the masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for a whole month. Mind you, Ibn Abbas was in i'tikaf. So when he went for this man, he told him that, I heard the Prophet saying that for you to help your brother is better than sitting in the masjid of the Prophet. Although the prayer there is for 1,000 prayers for every prayer that you have. Then Ibn Abbas went on to say to him, he said, وَمَنْ كَظَمَ غَيْظًا, like if you are at rage of a person and you can really destroy a person, if you really restrain your anger, restrain it, he said, مَلَأَ اللَّهُ قَلْبَهُ نُورٍ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will compensate you on the day of judgment by filling your heart with light at the time when he says يَوْمَ تَمُوتُ الْقُلُوبِ, because that day everybody was in a very difficult state. That day Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give the person that one. And he said, the Prophet goes on to say, he said, وَمَنْ كَفَّ غَضَبَهُ, like if you are angry with a person, you are also able to restrain it. He says, ثَبَّتَ اللَّهُ قَلْبَهُ يَمَّ تَغْمُوتُ الْقُلُوبِ. يعني that day also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will do it. So he took this man and actually finally he said to him, وَمَنْ مَشَى فِي حَاجَةَ أَخِيهِ حَتَّى يَغْضِيهَا لَهُ. He said, and it's not only that you try to help a person, but actually you go until you fulfill what the person has and make it easier for them. Then he said, Allah will compensate you in no way you can imagine on the day of judgment for what you can do for that. So basically, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as we said, on the one hand, he lived what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to him. And on the other hand, he taught his companions to do this because this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala compensated them for them. If you read, for instance, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, like especially feeding people, many people, like one of the things that they mentioned in the write-up that they gave to me, especially about feeding people. Look at this hadith of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. One says, the Prophet said, Wallahi la yu'min. By Allah, you are not a believer. Why? He said, Man bata shab'an. Like if you are sleeping with full belly and your neighbor is hungry, that will deprive you of the faith that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you. Another one. Look at what Allah says in the Quran, and this is what the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam fulfilled. On the day of judgment, some people will come and they find themselves in hellfire. And people will ask them, why are you here? What do they say? قَالُوا لَمْ نَكُمْ مِنَ الْمُصَلِّينَ. First thing, we didn't choose to pray. وَلَمْ نَكُمْ نُطْعِمُ الْمِسْكِينَ. And we were not feeding the poor or the hungry people. وَكُنَّا نَخُوضُ مَعَ الْخَائِضِينَ. يعني these are the things that if you notice, they're very simple things. كُنَّا نُكَذِّبُ بِيَوْمِ الدِّينَ. لَمْ نَكُمْ مِنَ الْمُصَلِّينَ. But also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala specifically said, وَلَمْ نَكُنْ نُطْعِمُ الْمِسْكِينَ. For those younger children, our grandchildren now, actually I say grandchildren or children, even the surahs that you take in very elementary school or primary classes, anyone knows Surah Al-Ma'un? Now, if you read the surah closely, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَرَأَيْتَ الَّذِي يُكَذِّبُ بِالدِّينَ. يُكَذِّبُ بِالدِّينَ. Who is he? فَذَٰلِكَ الَّذِي يَدُعُّ الْيَتِيمِ وَلَا يَحُضُّ عَلَىٰ طَعَامِ الْمِسْكِينِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, relates this to the whole, as if this whole deen. He says that يَدُعُّ الْيَتِيمِ means he shuns the orphan. He doesn't ask people or encourage them to feed people who are hungry. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, even on the day of judgment, among the things that can save people on the day of judgment, is when people have been feeding people and helping them just to elevate hunger from them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for instance, Surah Al-Insan, he says that these people who come on the day of judgment, look at the description that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that we didn't used to feed people. We didn't used to care about people who are hungry. We didn't used to extend the hand for people who are in need. And these are the things that can take everything from the person that we have. And the reason they will say that we were worried about this day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has warned us for it. For instance, when he says in Surah Al-Insan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala actually relates to this in a way that sometimes when you read it, you really yourself try to shrink, and you saw that your heart actually vibrates on it. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that we are feeding you, إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمُكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ لَا نُرِيدُ مِنْكُمْ جَزَاءً وَلَا شُكُورًا. We are feeding you for just solely for the sake of Allah. We don't want to have any like jaza or reward from you, or even to say thanks to us. Why? إِنَّا نَخَافُ مِنْ رَبِّنَا يَوْمًا عَبُوسًا قَمْطَرِيرًا. Because we are worried about that grim, difficult day. Allah says, فَوَقَاهُمُ اللَّهُ شَرَّ ذَلِكَ الْيَوْمِ وَلَقَّاهُمْ نَضْرَةً وَسُرُورًا وَجَزَاهُمْ بِمَا صَبَرُوا جَنَّةً وَحَرِيرًا. Like the reward was so great that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Allah protects them from the difficulty and the hardship of that day, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward them with the best places in paradise. This is why, as I said to you, if you look at all of these things and put them together, you will find that acts of worship, for instance, and I say this all the time for you, if you take every act of worship, the prayer, Jum'ah prayer, Siyam, Hajj, you will find that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not make it an end in itself. You just don't pray because you pray. Just for the sake of the prayer, or pray Jum'ah for the sake of the prayer, or fast because of the sake of fasting, or even for Hajj. These are to remind us and to keep track of us, like the five daily prayers. If you read after every prayer, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَإِذَا قَضَيْتُمُ الصَّلَاةِ when you finish your prayer, the prayer should not just end in the place where you prayed. The prayer should be the motivator to carry you to do the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to do, and to keep remembering Allah. And these two words, qada, and which means you fulfill the prayer as it is. فَإِذَا قَضَيْتُمُ الصَّلَاةِ, Allah says, فَذْكُرُ اللَّهَ قِيَامًا وَقُعُودًا وَعَلَى جُنُوبِكُمْ, that the prayer itself, when you charge yourself with it, every time you pray, that should lead you to do things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to do. Now, you see the same words are used for Jum'ah. For instance, on Friday, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَإِذَا قُضِيَتِ الصَّلَاةِ, that when you fulfill like Friday prayer and you finish it, he used the same. He said, فَذْكُرُ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ, which means you finish Friday prayer. And by the way, this happens many times, I've seen it. You see a brother praying Jum'ah. Immediately after he leaves the masjid, he goes and yells at his wife or yells at his children. And you wonder what this man benefits from this prayer he just finished, or the khutbah that is. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَإِذَا قَضَيْتُمُ الصَّلَاةِ, this in relation to Surah Jum'ah, فَذْكُرُ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. You see Ramadan. Ramadan, طبعاً, one of the major things about Ramadan is not just the hunger and the thirst that you have, but actually how to feel for the poor, how to feel how blessed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made you, how you reciprocate for the good things that Allah gave you for it. And the words that are used in Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلِتُكْمِلُوا الْعِدَّةِ وَلِتُكَبِّرُوا اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ, so that you fulfill the duration of the months of Ramadan, you come out of the Ramadan, and then you are able now to reciprocate for what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you, and to show gratitude to Allah for what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you. طبعاً, the peak of it is Hajj. Surprisingly, the same words are being used in Hajj. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَإِذَا قَضَيْتُم مَنَاسِكَكُمْ, when you fulfill all the manasik of Hajj, like you do your, like ihram, you do your tawaf, you do your sa'i, you do arafah, you do all of these things. Now, at the end of it, the end of this is not just to, some people get the title of Hajji and they call them Hajj and so on, but actually this should be the real relationship that you start with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or what Allah wants you to reciprocate. Look at the words of the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَإِذَا قَضَيْتُم مَنَاسِكَكُمْ فَذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَذِكْرِكُمْ آبَاءَكُمْ أَوْ أَشَدَّ ذِكْرًا. He said, now you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, reciprocate for this thing for Allah, the way you remember your own parents. Not only that, he said, أَوْ أَشَدَّ, which is even more than remembering your parents. Why? Allah tells us now, he said, فَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا وَمَا لَهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنْ خَلَاقٍ. There are so many people, they just, after this dunya, they invest everything in this dunya, but they don't have anything in the akhirah for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Allah wants us, and this is a dua Allah taught us, he says, وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَقُولُ رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنًا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنًا. By the way, this is the best dua that everyone should memorize it. And if Allah answers only one dua for any one of us, and this is the dua, you know what you do. Allah says, رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنًا. So Allah will give you in this dunya everything good. وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنًا. Allah will give you in the akhirah everything good. وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. And then save us from hellfire. You know, hellfire is hellfire. Many people don't take hellfire seriously. And there are some believers who will go to hellfire because of the things they do until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cleanses them. So you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you good in this dunya, good in the akhirah, and to save you completely. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all from hellfire. Now, that's how you reciprocate for things you do for the sake of Allah in this dunya, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala compensate you for the akhirah, inshallah. May Allah increase us in His rewards. May Allah bless all of you, inshallah. Jazakum Allahu khayran. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.